Birds. First at 10 tonight, we are digging deeper. Last November, a 10-year-old was accused of killing a 6-month-old baby by stomping on his head. In October, the young girl's case was moved to juvenile court in Chippewa County, so we'll likely never know how that story ends. News 18's Shannon Satterley dug deeper into the juvenile court system and to find out what happens to those juveniles whose records are sealed.
Last November, a case in Chippewa County shook our community to its core.
A new development in the case of the 10-year-old girl accused of killing a baby in Chippewa County.
Authorities say the 10-year-old girl confessed to dropping the child and repeatedly stomping on the baby's head.
There are a handful of crimes, probably less than a handful of crimes, for which a 10-year-old can be charged in adult court and must start out in adult court.
First-degree reckless homicide is one of them. That's what the 10-year-old was charged with. On October 11th, Judge James Peterson moved her case to juvenile court.
When a juvenile is charged as an adult, it's public record, and anybody can see what's going on in the case. But once the minor is charged as a juvenile, the public is left out of the loop. Recently, I sat down with the 10-year-old's attorneys. While they wouldn't talk about her case specifically, this isn't the first child they've represented.
Sometimes there are cases that come along that really require much more of your attention.
I don't know any 10-year-old or 11-year-old or 12-year-old, quite frankly, regardless of the seriousness of the delinquent act that was committed, who should be in adult court. And I felt that way as a prosecutor, and I feel that way as a defense attorney, because I know they don't understand what is happening.
Chippewa County District Attorney Wade Newell didn't prosecute this case, but says in juvenile court, the focus isn't on jail time, rather rehabilitation.
It's about what can we do to make the juvenile's life better, what can we do to help them so this doesn't happen again.
Sometimes they're placed at home, sometimes they're placed in detention, sometimes they might be placed in another facility.
There is a time limit though. Dunn County Judge Rod Smeltzer says most juveniles are released when they turn 18, unless they're still working toward their high school diploma. In some rare cases, they'll stay in the juvenile system well into their 20s.
Depending on the violation or the offense that the juvenile was involved in, like the serious juvenile offender program where you can keep the juveniles into a program till 21 or even up to 25, depending on if certain criteria is applied.
The last we knew, the young girl is at Northwest Regional Juvenile Detention Center in Eau Claire.
We do know she will never go to prison for the death of the baby she's accused of killing. The goal now is rehabilitation.
Data shows rehabilitation does not always occur. According to the nonpartisan, nonprofit organization Council of State Governments Justice Center, up to 80% of incarcerated youth are rearrested within 3 years of release in many states. Officials say the key to reducing that rate is to get them into programs to help them transition back into normal life.